then Sam and Frodo lived happily ever after the end. Boom! My novel is complete. Oh, hi there. Good to see you. My name is Jake Roper. Now, you might be asking yourself, Jacob, why is half of your hair buzzed? Well, that's a great question. It's not just because I really like the character Roger from the show Doug or Skrillex or any kind of combination of the two. It's because I'm working on a very secret project that looks like this. It's gonna be amazing. I'm very excited for it. But again, it is a secret. You know what else is a secret? Passwords. And that's what this dong is all about. Passwords. How secure is your password? Could you make it better? Maybe? Probably. Let's find out with some dongs. Things that you can do online now, guys. Time that one out, Hannah. First things first, let's test how secure your password is. So we'll go to howsecureismypassword.net, and we featured this on a dong before, but it's very useful in this situation. So let's try the password Michael Stevens. Ooh, look at that. It's gonna take about 51 years for a computer to crack, but look what happens if we add a 2. Now it has gone up from 51 years to 175,000 years. And sure, Michael Stevens 2 is not too difficult to remember, but many internet users have more than one account, and some even have close to 100. I mean, I have a different password for every account that I have, so it kind of gets a little bit difficult. But if you want to make strong passwords that are different for every account, like a moi, it can be hard to keep them all together. That's where a service like LastPass comes in, which I personally use and have been using for years, and they were also nice enough to sponsor this episode and support Vsauce and the dong. Now, LastPass is great because you don't have to memorize all your passwords. It stores all of them, which is convenient, but it also can autofill for you, because I always do the thing where I type in a password and it's not the right one and I keep typing it in until I get locked out of my account. This autofills it because there's plugins for your browser and there's also an app for your phone, which is very nice. Also, it can generate random passwords for you, which turn out to just be like a long string of numbers and letters, which is good for security. And you can try LastPass for free for as long as you want. No credit card required. Link at the top of the description, which is very nice. Now, passwords. Whew, how secure are they, really? Because in 2014, it was estimated that 47% of adults in the US had some personal information stolen. Now, to find out, we can use this hash generator. Hash values are generated by a one-way function, so you can get the hash value if you have the password, but not the password with just the hash value. And a variety of these hash-generating algorithms exist, but Computerphile has a great video that breaks down how SHA-1, a hash function, works. It has recently been replaced by more secure algorithms, but it was widely used for many years. And these irreversible functions don't mean a weak password protects you from theft or fraud, and I'll explain why in a little bit. For now, let's check the strength of yours. So let's type Michael Stevens into the hash generator. And this one uses SHA-1, but there are others as well. Okay, so typed in Michael Stevens. Here's our hash value. So let's just copy that. And now we can go to CrackStation to see if we can figure out what our password was from the hash we copied in. Figured it out almost immediately, and that's not a huge surprise because CrackStation draws from a 15 billion entry lookup table. Now add 1.5 billion entries for the remaining algorithm. A lookup table is a storage format that lists passwords next to their corresponding hash values. It sounds tedious to create, but when you realize that CrackStation can decrypt 20 passwords at once in a matter of seconds, it becomes easier to wrap your head around. And this brings me back to my point about the necessity of a strong password despite complex hashing algorithms. If you use a common one like password, you can be pretty sure that somewhere within those 16.5 billion entries exists a hash value for password. So what if we now hash Michael Stevens 2? Adding a number helps because it's a very easy form of salting. It adds a random string of characters, the salt, to the beginning or end of a password before it is hashed. It makes a password harder to crack because you can't use a lookup table since it's impossible to predict what the salt is. And if you were hoping for a generator to create a salted password, well, we've got you covered with salt the pass. So let's try one of those easily hackable passwords like password. Great. Now let's copy it and put it into CrackStation. So I know what you're thinking, Jake. $$ Michael Stevens fan 345 number sign 2508 is too hard to remember. How do I stay safe from ill-intentioned people trying to steal all my stuff? Easy, my friend, with passphrases. A random collection of words like zebra, dance, onion, parachute. But what if that isn't random? I mean, for me it probably is because I've never been with all four of those things at the same time. But what if I had. What if a hacker knows that I love all those things and can guess it? That's where Diceware Passphrase comes in. This method makes sure the words you choose are 100% random. Each word in the given list corresponds with 5 numbers. Roll a die 5 times, write down the digits, and select your first word. Now, keep doing that until you get however many words you want. And if that rolling seems a little too tedious for you, then good news, there's this dice simulator right here that lets you click a button for 5 rolls simultaneously. Please comment your 3-word passphrase below, and also whatever salt you added to it. Okay, now good luck finding it in a lookup table, which, by the way, may be an efficient strategy for nefarious people. But the drawback is that it takes up a lot of storage. For the low storage hacking solution, there's the brute force method. You've probably heard of this technique before. It's essentially just trial and error. The hacker guesses different combinations of passwords until they get the correct one. And there are programs to make it go faster, like John the Ripper, but brute force is one of the slowest, the most tedious methods. So we can actually check this out. If we go to betterbuys.com, you'll see how quickly your password would be figured out using brute force. And it's really cool to see just how by adding a few numbers, you can increase the time it takes to hack by a matter of years or millennia or even an infinity. You can also see how it would differ depending on the year and the computer processing power. So we're gonna set it to 2018 and it would take 135 millennia. Okay, now if we make it password, it will take 0.2 milliseconds. But if we set it to the year 1982, it would take 39 jiffies, which is fantastic. Because I love the word jiffy. A jiffy is an unspecified short period of time. So when people tell you they'll be back in a jiffy and they don't come back for years, you can call them a liar. Still waiting for you to come back, Michael Stevens. Said you were going to the grocery store and you never came back, just left mom and I alone. Anyway, as technology evolves and hackers become more proficient, cracking passwords becomes faster and faster. And the point of all this, let me close this, we're gonna get a little one-on-one time. Point of all this isn't to scare you, really. One, I think it's just cool to kind of see how secure your password is and just play around with it. The other is that security is important on the internet. I get an email pretty much every day from one of my accounts saying that someone's tried to reset my password. So that's why I think this is very valuable to investigate, you know? Do it with your friends, check some passwords. That's what I do on a nice Friday night. Just check for passwords, wait for dad to come home, and yes, so there's links to the dongs down in the description. If you want to check out LastPass, which I would highly recommend, I really, really like their software. There's a link down there as well at the top of the description. And what was that? Yeah, as always, dad, come home. Thanks for watching.